Today's video, we're going to be breaking down some Madden 16 Draft Champions gameplay. What's up, guys? My name is Cody Bauer. I like to make Madden 16 videos and post them on the internet. Today, we're going to be taking a look at our Game 3 and our climb here to the Draft Champions Championship here. We're coming out, playing our opponent here, looking like it's going to come out in a 3-wide, but kind of the same philosophy that we've had with all the other games in this series is we like to come out and just play simple football. Like to come out, let our opponent have the underneath stuff, and then we're going to try and take away that over the top stuff. So, you know, if they're willing to take slant routes and things like that, you know, they will have some success against us early on, and then we'll be able to take that away, you know, as we continue down the drive, continue down the field. So that's definitely what we look to do with this game mode. We like to send pressure off from the short side of the field. I like to use a $3-2-6 as well. I haven't seen many people running this, but I really think that it's a decent package for us. And you see here, I mean, not too bad against the run. Able to blow it up in the backfield with Matthews. But pretty simple philosophy. I mean, pretty simple game for us right now. I mean, you know, this isn't anything too complicated. The cool part about this is that right there, when they make the mistake of trying to get us over the top, and that's what I want to note here with this philosophy and kind of way we play. As you see, we get a nice sack fumble. We like to take advantage of people who try to take advantage of us, and what this means is that if they're going to try to do play actions, or they're going to try to do screens, or they're going to try to do deep vertical passes or plays like that, they're going to try to take advantage of aggressive defenses. You know, our defense is going to do a nice job. Of really, kind of staying at home against those types of things. Offensively, we try to stay simple as well. We just try to, make simple, easy reads. Try to keep the ball moving forward. A lot of running. That's why we picked Terrell Davis, because he's one of the better running backs in the game. With his 95 trucking rating, he does a really nice job for us. In my opinion, he's the best running back I've ever used on Madden. But that's, I don't get the opportunity to get those elite guys very often because I don't play enough solo challenges for my good. But anyway, so that we like to use Terrell Davis here. I like to be simple. I like to have a nice, and there is a nice little spin move. I just think that running the football this year is very, very good. And so I like to, I like to stay small, stay simple. I talk about it a lot, but truly staying simple, not trying to do too much offensively, just trying to keep the ball moving forward. In this situation, we're just trying to power it, and we really are. We're just trying to kind of move forward, move forward, move forward, and eventually we will throw the ball if we need to. And also in situations where, we really like to, kind of lull our defense to sleep, force them to have to really kind of look at this. And we like to look at safeties, and we like to say, okay, we'll throw this short underneath route and take a loss of yardage, maybe even, or just a short small gain. But what we're looking at is different shot plays with contention. The reason we throw a fade on 3rd and 2 as opposed to throwing a fade on 3rd and 8, there's a reason behind all that. And so that's what we really like to do. As you see here, we're going to go ahead and go in and score with Davis. A nice opening drive there. Reason I ran the ball 3rd and 8. I talk about it all the time. I think that Madden is a matter of possessions, and if you can be good at going up possessions, it's more important than going up touchdowns. So I was perfectly content with going up one possession with just a field goal from that drive, but I did get the touchdown. I got Davis broke a tackle, and it opened up for us. So I also like to go for 2 just to show you guys more looks. There is more in-depth reasons as to why I go for 2, but I mean, this is pretty much a kind of a nice pattern for us. I mean, the last couple times we played this mode, defensively we've been able to come out, we've been able to get a stop or a turnover, we've been able to turn it into points, and defensively now we come out and now we have the opportunity to kind of put him in a 2-minute drill, and this is kind of where you really have to be good. I mean, this is prime time mode. I mean, for these guys, 2-minute drill is kind of where they can really make their money. And this is where your defense has to flat out be good. We can do tactics and things like that all day, but again, eventually you have to lock up. And this is one of those situations where, defensively, right now this is a key situation where we're going to have to really kind of lock up and play good solid defense. Like to keep everything in front of us, but again, with the amount of time he has on the clock, the fact that he has three timeouts, we're going to have to just play really solid defense. We're actually going to jump out of the four, that formation. We're going to go into our money formation, the 4-3 under. This is the formation we really like to use out of this book. And, really like to just be simple. I mean, I hesitate to say this because it sounds like, we're not very elite. And I don't know that I am necessarily elite, but I feel like Madden's not so much about being elite. It's not about having the best pressure, having the best blitz. While we can have some of that, it's more about being able to call it at the right time. And here you see we get roasted over the top. And he's going to go in for six. And I think it's just because we didn't have our safety in our deep look zone. But we, being aggressive, and that's part of the game. Calculate a risk and things like that. We take a risk there because we still have 2 minutes to come down and score. So it really makes sense as to why we would take the risk there as opposed to waiting until, 30, 40 seconds left in the game where we're not going to touch the ball again. At that point, we have to keep everything in front of us and really, truly stay disciplined to our game plan. So, but anyway, coming out here, trying to go down and score. I mean, this is where Eli Manning's going to make his money. I mean, this is where the offense has to be elite, and we drafted an elite offense, in my opinion, Terrell Davis, and a nice offensive line. The other thing we forgot to do, I think, in the opening drive here, was we forgot to put our guy Sullivan in the right guard spot for the counter, and that's something that's a little thing that we can't forget to do. I mean, I'm convinced that Madden is a lot of little things adding up to a big result. So here he goes, man, and we're able to hit a nice drag pattern. And this is no huddle city. I mean, this is where, this is where we have to, be consistent. And, we'll mix in outside zones as long as we keep the drive going. I mean, this is really all about, and now this is a key third down, a key third and seven. We have to be able to convert here. And oh, terrible throw by Eli Manning. Oh, that was awful. So fourth down, we don't convert, quite simply, when we mess up, and we have to punt the ball. We have to play the field position game. We have to be wise and understand that we're going to get the ball coming out of halftime. But so that's a tough one as well. I mean, this is probably going to be the hardest game we've going to have, I mean, so far. I mean, it's already starting out like that. Now this is a situation we cannot make another mistake. We have to play disciplined defense here. We can't try to get a sack fumble or something big. We have to really play disciplined defense here. And so we're going to hop into our nickel wide nine package. We have to keep everything in front of us. There's a big hit by Godfrey. And like I said, I mean, this is all about calculated risks, knowing when to blitz versus when to play coverage versus when to do anything. I mean, everything we do defensively has a risk and reward to it. So another slant. It seems like he likes the quick slants. So that's something interesting. Here we're going to cover three buzz. We're going to man up on the outside to try to take away some of this stuff. So we're only going to send one with the quick slants. What's interesting to note is the way that he continues to run it, even though it's taking his timeouts. So we're going to try and clamp down on him here with this mic edge. So quick pressure. There's Jim Leonard making a big play, and the defense gets a big time turnover. Another really good job. And like I said, real quickly, I mean, if you guys want a defense like this, it has really good potential to get pressure and to have good potential to get play nice coverage defenses and get you some turnovers, guys, look no further than our defensive guide. I mean, you can check that out in the description. I mean, there you see it again, getting a nice big stop for us. We break down all of our defensive stuff in the guide for you, so if you want to check that out, like I said, I mean, it's pretty cheap, it's pretty inexpensive, and I think it really can help out some people. So you know, I definitely encourage you to check that out. Offensively here, we're just trying to score. We really need to score a touchdown here, so we need to get moving down the field. There's a big catch by Jimmy Graham and a dot by Eli Manning. I mean, that's a big one right there. I mean, the defense went with a heavy pressure blitz to try to force us into a turnover, and we just shamed them. I mean, we threw that one, and that was a really good catch by Jimmy Graham to make that play. This situation here, Larry Fitzgerald has got to come through for us. We've got 19 seconds, three timeouts. We're going to go ahead and run it. He gives us a nice look here, and Terrell Davis is going to go ahead and get down inside his 5-yard line. I mean, right here, and this is where we better make our money. I mean, this is where offensively we have to score a touchdown. We cannot score a field goal. I mean, with this situation, we have a really good opportunity here. And we can't take a sack there. That was terrible. Eli Manning really frustrated. We wanted to go play action there. We made the mistake, and I mean, that was really a mistake. A terrible play call by me. And now we have to... Crap, I flipped the play on accident. So, a lot of confusion offensively here. And we need Jimmy Graham to be big for us on this crossing pattern. There's Jimmy Graham getting us back in a scoring position. We got 6 seconds. Quite simply, what we're looking to do here is we're looking to throw a fade pattern. And if the fade pattern is double covered, we're going to come out in that twin tight end look. And if the fade pattern is double covered, we'll go ahead and run a quick pitch if we have a look there. Otherwise, we'll take a delay a game if needed. But this is where we got to be big. I mean, this is where Jimmy Graham, I mean, being 6'7", he's got to come up big for us. Put an extra lineman out there. Sullivan out there. We need to bring in a fullback. And this is where we have to score. I mean, we got a one-on-one look, so we're going to go play action. Max protect. Looking to Jimmy Graham. And we weren't able to throw it. So we're going to have and got rid of the football. What's interesting is that he seems to pass commit more. So that means that we're not going to be able to, you know, we're just not going to be able to throw those fades off of play action. We're going to have to go ahead and block that running back. He's going to commit to making us do that. They took the squibs out this year, which I don't really understand why, so we're going to just have to kick it short. We'll kick it right out of bounds here, give him one opportunity to throw a fade. I'd rather kick it out of bounds and give him the ball at the 45 and play prevent than give him an opportunity to run it back and kick on me. So, and the dollar... Man, we send the pressure. And normally they will catch that. I'll just be honest with you. Normally they will catch that. So you just need to be prepared to make a tackle. So offensively now, we've got to come down and we've really got to make a statement drive. I mean, this is where the offense has to be really solid. We have to go down and score a touchdown. I mean, no questions about it. We cannot take a field goal in this situation. We are up by one possession, but we need to get up by two. And so we really need to score here. I mean, this is a really important drive for us. So to come out, I like to open up with a quick screen pass if we get a look for it. So we'll come out in it. And you see we do have a nice look for it with the backed off coverage. So we're going to look to it here. Brandon Cooks with that nice speed, and that's a big play. Looks like he was probably trying to stop the run, and Brandon Cooks is going to go in for 6 here. So a really big opening play for us to get in the end zone, and a really big statement right there right off the bat. So it sent some pressure there, as you see there, to stop the running offense that we've been hitting him with, and we're able to get the ball in here. Now we have a nice look to run this pitch here. We'll bring Jimmy Graham across the formation, 6'7". He needs to get out there, lay a pancake block on the corner, get Terrell Davis into the end zone for 2 points. So really good really good drive opening up offensively. So now defensively, we just have to lock in. I mean, this is where we, you know, this is where the defense has to, you know, bend but don't break, keep everything in front of them. We're up by two possessions, so defensively, we just got to stay small. What I like to do in situations like this, like I said, is go back to that dollar. I really like the Mike Ed 1 scheme, little mini scheme, and I like to keep everything in front of me with it. So we can get here. And there was a little 0-1 trap there, and I really like said, you know, I think this is really solid defense. I mean, we're only sending three guys at the quarterback. We're able to get decent pressure. We're able to stop the run. We're really able to kind of play solid against the pass. I mean, there you see, I mean, solid run defense. I mean, he gets the first down because he's Jeremy Hill and just powers through us. But, you know, we had the opportunity to stop it. And really appreciate that. The more you dive into Madden this year, the more you're going to find that it may not, it's not necessarily about getting, you know, super crazy fast A-gap pressure all the time. It's about being strategic. It's about being able to stop the run, being able to stop the pass, not being able to get sacks, but being able to stop the pass. They're two good things. And offensively, you know, this game definitely tailors to, you know, the people that like to, you know, like to be simple, like to make good reads. And that's what we're just trying to do here. I mean, we're just trying to keep everything in front of us. I mean, I'm not trying to be too complicated. You know, that's the last thing I want to do. So, cover two man, in my opinion, is two men under even, as those two defenses are really solid for us this year as well. The thing about the 3-2-6 is that you can really play some solid max coverage defense with the being able to take those vertical routes away. And there we just got mossed on the outside there by Vincent Jackson. So a nice play by him. First and goal. And this is where we send a lot of guys in the box. And this is where I really kind of... this is where we send the heat. I mean, this is where we bring it. So here probably looking to run it left side. Nice catch by Hill. So second and goal, we're looking to accomplish here. I mean, this is all out. I mean, this is where you got to really kind of stand your ground. So we'll look to go 4-3 under. What we're going to try to do, though, is we're going to try to force him to run the ball against us. So we're going to set up a nice pass defense and see what he does. Runs a nice dive and get a nice block shed, and that'll take us to the 2-minute warning. So 2-minute warning here, third and goal. This is a crucial down. What we're looking to do here, probably going to be a pass. So what we like to do is come out of this Mike Edge 3 show 2, send some passive pressure. Really trying to set up some coverage, and we weren't able to stop him. He ends up going ahead and going into the end zone. Mike Wallace, nice catch. And so now it leaves it up to us. I mean, a couple first downs, we can really seal the deal here. Offense has to be good. I mean, and this was a really solid game. I mean, offensively, you know, he really had his reads down, was able to take the underneath stuff and drive up us on the field here. Cool part is this is going to put us in a nice situation because we have three timeouts. With him having three timeouts left, we can't be lackadaisical. I mean, offense has to be solid here. The key is that we cannot just run the ball. This is a situation where the offense has to get a first down. So, you know, we're just going to stay with our basic reads here and just try to keep going forward here. Outside zone, outside zone, outside zone. There, Terrell Davis makes a big-time run. Puts us in a good situation here. Second and short. This is where we like to take shots. And so what we're going to do is We're going to put Brandon Cooks in the slot here. We'll come out. If he gives us a good look for the pitch, we'll take it because that'll give us an automatic first down. But if not, and here he gives us a decent look. We could probably pick the first down up. We're going to go ahead and go inside. And actually, he checks out. So we're going to put Brandon Cooks on a streak pattern, max protect, and our only read here is Cooks. We're going to snap Graham as if he was running the pitch to us. And we'll go ahead and take our, you know, send some nice heat at us. I don't know what he did there to get that pressure, but really solid. And so here we've got to get a first down. This is where we really kind of have to let Terrell Davis work. I mean, and we're going to actually quick snap him here because he looks like he's going to give it to us. Terrell Davis gets stuffed in the backfield. And so fourth and one, we're going to bring out our full arsenal. We have to go for this. This is essential. I mean, it's essential that we make this. I mean, this is really the ball game right here. I mean, if we don't make this, I mean, he really has a good shot at beating us, going down and getting a touchdown. So, offensively, you know, this is where we're going to have to really, really look to get him here. I mean, we're really looking outside zone. I mean, that's the main thing we're looking to do here. He does give us a nice look for it. And Terrell Davis is going to spin back inside and pick up the first down, a big-time conversion for us. And now we can really check out and really kind of run the clock down. So a solid drive here for the offense, a couple of little chess moves here and there, but able to really kind of convert when we needed to. And Terrell Davis really working this inside zone masterfully. You know, not as big of a game for him today. I mean, they really did keep him in check a little bit, but offensively able to really open up some of the passing lanes and things that he's able to do for us. So a nice game by Terrell Davis. Going to close us out here with some off-tackle running. Like I said, if you want offense and defensive breakdowns that are really going to teach you the ins and outs of having plays like this that are really able to, you know, net you some really good success, I would look no further than the description below, where you're going to find all of my Madden 16 products, where I break down full offense, full defense for you know, a pretty good price, in my opinion, too. So you can check all that out. But with that being said, guys, that's all we've got for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this gameplay. Tried to, you know, show you some nice Draft Champions gameplay. We'll see you guys next time. Make sure